peace. I just wanted to take a moment to follow up my most recent video, Then Why Did God Make Devil? Because I received a lot of good responses from people, and I wanted to just take a moment to address the most common response that I've gotten from people who wanted more clarity on God making the devil. Because a lot of people have been taught, or they believe, that God did not make the devil, and that the devil is somehow outside of the sphere of influence of someone who's considered to be all-knowing, all-powerful, and omnipresent. So just wanted to take a moment and clarify our perspective on that as a 5%. Like I said in that video, God made devil. That's what we teach, and we teach that God made all things in creation, which includes the devil. And some people think very dichotomously. They think that things are either this or they're that. It's difficult sometimes for people to conceptualize how things can be a little bit of both or neither, right? And when we look at creation, we understand that everything we see with our physical eye is actually governed by a set of prerequisites that are laws. Those laws determine how that aspect of creation is going to function or operate. So when you're looking at anything in creation, when we talk about math being the operating system of the universe, everything functions or operates in a sequential order. When you look at the periodic table in chemistry, you can see how the gaseous elements eventually yielded the heavier isotopes, or all the way down to the alkaline metals. One aspect of creation precedes something else. So we live in a universe that's interdependent. Nothing operates in and of itself. Everything is the consequence or the result of something that preceded it. Even when you look at humans, you have genotypes and you have the phenotype. The phenotype is the appearance, what you actually see on the outside. But that is really the manifestation of what actually takes place on the inside, meaning the genotype. So the genotype precedes the phenotype. It's like that in every aspect of creation. So even when you're talking about the devil being an adversary or oppositional, devil, just like everything in creation which has a choice, can do whatever the devil chooses to do, but there are always going to be consequences. And that's what people oftentimes don't understand. For example, I can go to the dollar store right now and buy me a 64-ounce bottle of bleach. I can drink that bottle of bleach if I choose to, but there are going to be consequences to my actions. Something is going to follow what I choose to do. Now, I have the free will to do it, right? But what is going to be the result of that? So it's the exact same thing with devil. Devil was made because creation pre-existed the devil. When the devil was made or manufactured in the creation, the devil, by nature, is the poster child of ODD, oppositional defiance disorder. And when you look up the definition of oppositional defiance disorder, you will realize that it's actually talking about the type of behavior that a child demonstrates that is antagonistic towards authority. And that's essentially what the devil represents. But at the same time, to see that opposite side of the spectrum, primarily in humanity, is important to show forth the true power of that one which is all-knowing, which is omnipresent, which is all-powerful. How would you even know that sphere of influence if it's not tested, if you don't see those limits? So that is what I wanted to just take a moment and clarify for those who come from a perspective that believe that we just have free will and we can do what we want. Yeah, you got free will, you could do whatever you want, but there's always going to be consequences, because regardless of what you choose to do in the creation, there are laws or prerequisites that governs the creation itself. And you have various different people that do experimentation, and they do all different type of things to see if they can bend some of those laws or those prerequisites that governs the creation. And there are always going to be consequences to that. We teach that our best approach towards living is to align ourselves with those prerequisites or with those laws that governs creation. The same way Adam was taught to do that in the beginning, when you're looking at it from a biblical perspective. But you see what happened with that particular story. And that from the perspective of some people who are Christian or that live according to that belief system, look at that as the departure of Adam's relationship with the Creator. So I will, this was inspiring, it was empowering, it was educational, gave those of you a little bit more clarity on why we teach that God made devil. Yeah, God made all things, and there is nothing outside of that sphere of influence that we consider to be all-powerful, omnipresent, and all-knowing. Peace.